Ništa, onda počnem sa predstavljanjem.
Zovem se Dragan Jokic.
Yes, he was born in on 28th of March 1953 in Uroševac, Kosovo. His name is Mr. Dragan Jokic. He was born in Uroševac and he used to live there since June this year.
And what was his address
then? The address is
can you repeat the address again?
Stari Skopski Put, number 3.
Do 14.8. Ovo je 6. Živjeli smo normalno. I sa komšijama Albancima i sa Srbima. Mm-hmm. Uradili smo do to vreme dve kuće. Vlasnik sam privatne firme Bojana Trade koja ima 17 radnika.
So till 14th of June this year, Mr. Jokic used to live in his native town Uroševac. He and his family succeeded to build two houses and to make themselves a living from the forwarding trading company, which was employing 17 people. And all these times they used to maintain a good relation with their both Serbian and Albanian neighbors.
14.8. uzeo sam
6.
Ovaj 6. Uzeo sam dve ćerke i ženu, a sin nije teo da dođe.
On 14th of June he took his two daughters and spouse.
Ostao sa
the son did not want to leave Kosovo.
Nije teo da dođe, ostao sa ocem i majkom.
And he remained
bio veliki patriota.
And he remained in Uroševac with his grandfather and grandmother, that means parents of Mr. Jokic, because he felt very much patriotic and he did not want to leave Kosovo.
18.8. sam se, ovaj 6. vratio sam se iz Leskovca da uzmem sina.
On 18th of June this year, Mr. Jokic returned from Leskovac back to Uroševac to take his son with him.
Otac i majka nisu hteli da dođu.
And he did it while his parents rejected to leave Kosovo. Probably not even more than 10 minutes after he left with the car and his son in it for Serbia, Mr. Jokic received information that after only 10 or 15 minutes from their leave, one car with three Albanian people and some foreign TV, suspectedly Irish TV people. They visited the house of his parents, and among other questions they emphasized why didn't you leave Kosovo as well. So my father was killed on 24th of June at 8:00 a.m. And before this he was attacked three times.
On nije hteo nikako da izađe iz kuće.
My father rejected to leave the house in spite of several threats made by Albanians. Always repeating to those Albanians who threatened him that he didn't do any harm to them or to any other neighbors, and that he refused to leave because he doesn't feel responsible for anything. At the moment when Mr. Jokic's father was killed, his mother used to be in the bathroom.
Tri puta su se vraćali da pucaju na njega.
The
automatom, mislim, rafalno, jedan put, pa drugi put, pa treći put, što je to stvarno.
In fact, his father was shot by an automatic shotgun. And after they killed him, like it was previously explained, they returned other two times and they shot, I don't know how to say it, several shots with the automatic gun on a dead body of his father.
Majka je pobegla do skupštine opštine, mislim to je jedno 500 metara od kuće, taj dan. Mislim, posle toga.
Na dan ubistva.
Na dan ubistva.
Later on the day of killing of his father, his mother succeeded to escape from the house and she went to municipality office in Uroševac.
Do KFOR-a.
She contacted KFOR authorities.
No, KFOR je došao, uzeo leš.
KFOR accepted the call and they took the corpse from the house.
The corpse?
Yes. So KFOR kept the corpse in local hospital for one night, and the next morning they buried him without any signs, just put him in a plastic bag. Later on, his mother succeeded to identify the place of burial, and she managed to put a wooden cross, simple wooden cross without any marks. And also KFOR helped his mother to be moved to neighboring city. Koje mesto su prebacili?
Na gradsko groblje. A oni do Livač, selo Livač.
The mother was transferred to the village called Livače. In this very moment, the mother, the old lady, is in Gračanica, also in Kosovo, to some other relative, his brother, her brother, that means his uncle. Mr. Jokic is arranging for her to come to Belgrade because he doesn't see any other alternative. And he has no other choice but to continue living here in Belgrade.
Let me ask you, how much property did you leave behind in Kosovo?
First of all, 4 hectares of land.
Tri kuće.
Opiši ih. Mislim, kao...
300 kvadrat.
Sve zajedno.
Zajedno.
Three houses totaling approximately 300 square meters. Some agricultural machineries.
Tractors. To mislim ono što treba za pojedino selo, mislim za sve poljoprivredne mašine.
And other hardware and that.
Does he have any idea what's happening with his houses at the moment?
Da li ti je poznato šta se sada sa tim vlasništvom dešava?
Spalili su sve. I poravnali.
All three houses were torched,
burnt,
and not only burnt, but also flattened with some leveled. Yes.
Does he think his mother is in any danger at the moment?
No, in his opinion, his mother is not in immediate danger because the area and the place of Gračanica is. With a lot of Serbs, and there is a special protection of KFOR around. And seemingly KFOR is organized to protect this small enclave of Serbian people.
Because there are so many Serbs there, does he think that's the reason?
Da li je to razlog tome da je zaštita KFOR-a dobra, to što su tu koncentrisani Srbi sad trenutno?
Pa sad trenutno jest. Sad trenutno jest.
Yes. This is, in his opinion, general situation where Serbian people are concentrated in some villages where they represent majority. In these places, KFOR is giving good protection. The problem is where people are scattered in small groups. Unfortunately, Mr. Jokic wants to emphasize that his story is not the individual story. There are so many cases similar to this one.
Da je, mislim da su mnogi moji prijatelji isto doživjeli tragediju koju ja sam doživio.
And many of my personal friends experienced the same tragedy like I did. And in all of these cities of Kosovo, which he listed, no need to translate, he has friends who suffered even the bigger tragedy than his.
Would he say then that the removal in this way of Serbs from these areas where they don't have a clear majority is systematic.
Yes, it is an obvious systematic cleansing, but he wants to add and emphasize that among the group of the people he knows, his friends and relatives living temporarily here in Serbia, all of them have a firm intention to return. They are not certain about when and how, but they are dedicated and firm to do this.
I'm struck by the contradiction between KFOR's apparent willingness to protect the Serbs in some areas where they're in the majority, and on the other hand, it sounds like, and I would like him to clarify this, that they didn't even bother to do any investigation as to his father's death and the causes of it and the perpetrators and to bring any justice to that. Could you ask him about that?
Yes, he doesn't want to speculate, is it a certain policy of KFOR not to protect Serbs where they do not represent majority, or even more than this, they support this kind of systematic cleansing. He doesn't want to speculate, but he added that he is much more disappointed as a human person by the behavior of Albanian neighbors, because KFOR will stay in Kosovo 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, but definitely someday they will leave, and who will remain forever are neighbors. So he is personally very much touched by the fact that no one among Albanian neighbors did not try to make any move to defend his parents, knowing the fact that they always used to live in kind of harmony. Okay, so he cannot be 100% sure in this moment, but so far what he succeeded to hear from as an evidence from his mother over the telephone discussions, there is a great probability that one of the killers was one of the neighbors, and that is one of very fresh neighbors who moved into the neighborhood only 1.5 years ago from other part of Kosovo.
What is his name?
That neighbor used to take over the house, buying the house from previous Serbian owners.
Yeah.
And then he moved in some 1.5 years ago. He doesn't know him by name, but the mother does.
Viđao sam od četiri brata su, mislim, četvorica braća su, video sam jednog u uniformi.
There are these neighbors, is not only one, these are four brothers. And even before Mr. Jokic left Kosovo, he saw one of these four brothers wearing a KLA uniform. Just to give you some description about the micro-locality of the neighborhood. This particular house is impossible to be identified by external people because it is located exactly among other houses, which are all Albanian houses. So for instance, for some people which comes from Albania or Macedonia or anything else, it would be absolutely impossible to identify this Serbian house among so many Albanian houses. So indirectly he is concluding that some of his neighbors made a clear indication about the target. Most of these KLA people used to have the kind of AK or Kalashnikov or stuff like that.
He said that his friends that he knows that are refugees here in Serbia are bound and determined to return to Kosovo. Does he himself intend to return at the earliest opportunity?
Yes, he already replied to it. Yes, he is determined to return. My personal opinion is that the motive for all of this problem is purely economical. Možeš to malo da
elaboriraš? Kosovo je bogato.
Kosovo is a rich region.
Mislim, znamo da posjeduje zlato, srebro, olovo, cink, feronikal, ugalj.
We know that there are many minerals and precious metals existing over there in deposit. And in his opinion, the real motive is to exploit these resources, natural resources, regardless of presence of both Serbian and Albanian people.
Zato stradaju i Srbi i Albanci.
That's why victims are both Serbians and Albanians.
Yeah, I'd like to ask one last question too. The American people have been given to understand through our mendacious media that the prior to the involvement of NATO, that there was ethnic cleansing going on by the Serbs against the Albanians. And since he was living there at that time, I wondered if he could respond to that and tell us his opinion of that idea and what he actually thought.
Okay, let's return only 2 years in the past.
It's fine.
Albanian people, they wanted to keep Kosovo exclusively for Albanian people. No, there was no ethnical cleansing of Albanian people by Serbian people. Before the war, then if you are interested to hear something about the situation during the war, before the war, no. The answer to your question is no. I am 46 years old and I live all my life in Kosovo. I do not know one single case where Albanian was forced to leave Kosovo. Of course, many Albanians left, but by economical reason, because they live in big families of minimum 10 members of the family, and out of these 10, in average two or three of them used to work as physical workers in Western Europe to contribute financially the welfare of the family or group of families. But this was not enforced by any Serbian action. That was purely economical motive to immigrate.
Ali su stvarali na Kosovu. Davali su, mislim, donosili su novci, pravili kuće,
but
stvarali
of course, su the money earned in the West has returned to Kosovo and contributed to the welfare of not only these families, but Kosovo in general.
Right. Well, we also know that many of the Albanians that were working in Europe were sending some of their money back to help support the KLA as part of an understanding that was forced on them.
Yes, there were cases known to him. Yes, I can give you an example of my business friend who is Albanian running the similar company like mine.
On je morao da plaća i državi Srbiji porez, a ujedno i njima negde oko 500 maraka mesečno bilo.
In our private discussions, my Albanian friend opened himself to me and he complained that he is forced to pay the tax to the state of Serbia, which is more or less, or is normal. Okay. And on top of that, every month he was forced to pay 500 Deutschmark for a special fund for Albanian common thing, which is in fact KLA. And if you would be physically able to interview this Albanian guy, he would confirm to you the same.
Who ultimately will benefit from this? Who are the ultimate exploiters of this, and who will benefit from this war?
Politicians.
Which politicians? From what country?
Na političare koji ostaju. Koji su ostali na Kosovu u Srbiji, to je po meni Momo Trajković i Artemije, koji hoće da iskoriste tragediju Srba tamo koji su ostali i sad trenutno Hašim Tači.
These are first of all Albanian leaders like Tači guy, but also some Serbian people who nominated themselves as new leaders. That means this Orthodox leader Artemije and Momčilo Trajković, who is a leader of one minor party. That party used to be minor, but now in the eyes of KFOR and the civil authorities, they represent all the Serbs in these days. So in Mr. Jokic's opinion, the immediate benefit will be shared between Albanians and the smaller part for these two Serbian leaders.
Okay, I think we reached the end of the interview, but we really want to thank him for his frankness, his candor, and for sharing this vital information that has been denied to the American people and that we hope we'll be able to transmit for him.